Students, how are you doing today? I hope you all are fine and doing well. So, today we learned value education fourth lesson. That name is a good neighbor. Do you know who are neighbors? Who we call neighbors? So, let's learn first ki who are neighbors, right? So, as we start lesson, first we learn about neighbors. Neighbors, as I said, these are the people who live surrounding us. As we are the neighbor of them and they are the neighbor of ours. We all are the neighbors of each other, right? So, as this perspective, we always wish that the other people can help us. So it's our duty also, we also can help everyone, right? At least our neighbors, right? So through this lesson, we can learn what is neighbor and neighborhood. And the main thing is about good neighbor, becoming a good neighbor. So let's start our lesson. So students, as you see on your screen, fourth lesson of value education, good neighbor, a good neighbor. As I said, what is a good neighbor? Look at this, thanks. Good neighbors help each other. That means, if we want a neighbor, a good neighbor, we can always help each other who lives surrounding us. That's the way we become a good neighbor. Before start a lesson, here's something I tell you. So if you are tired and hungry, you get off your school bus. Your mommy is waiting for you at the bus stop. Your neighbor is standing there alone. No one has come to pick him up from home. Everyone walks away. He is scared. What will you do? So here's two options. Hold mommy's hand and walk away, like everyone do. Or you can tell mommy to wait with him till someone comes. What do you think? Yes, it's a second option. Tell mommy to wait with him till someone comes to pick him up. So you can tick the second option right here. Now we have to start our chapter. That is helpful neighbors. Let's start. Harry is Karina's new neighbor. One day, Karina comes home from school. Her house is locked. There is no one at home. So she is tired and hungry. Harry sees Karina. He asks, Karina, why are you standing here? Is Auntie not at home? Karina says, no, she is not. I'm worried. She is always at home when I come back from school. Now, the Karina is worried. We all worried, right? As we couldn't find our mother at home the time we come from school. Harry says, don't worry, Karina, come to my house. They go in. Harry tells his mother everything. She quickly calls up Karina's mother. She says, I am stuck in a traffic jam. I don't know how much time it will take. I am worried about Karina. Harry's mother says, do not worry because Karina will stay with us till you come. That's like a good neighbor, right? Harry and his mother serve Karina to lunch. They look after her very well. Karina's mother comes back after some time. As she comes, she thanks Harry and his mother. From that day, they become very good friends. And now, after this story, this good story, we can learn how to become a good neighbor, isn't it? Now, it's question time. Circle the correct answer. As you see in your screen, these are options. The red one, either this one or this one. You just circle on them, right? So let's read. First one is, Harry is Karina's new teacher or neighbor. So right one is neighbor, right? You can simply circle with your pencil like this in your textbook only. Second, Harry takes Karina to his house or school. So, what is the right answer? House. Circle on it. Third, Karina's mother or father is stuck in a traffic jam. So, who's stuck? Mother. Circle on it. Fourth, Harry and his mother serve nothing. Lunch to Karina. So there are two options. What is right? Lunch. You can circle here. Fifth one is, Harry is a good or a bad neighbor. He is a very good neighbor, right? So you can circle on here. Now it's a time to think and read another example with a good neighbor, like a good neighbor. Who are the good neighbors, right? Through this poem. Read the poem with me. Golu and me. Golu is my neighbor. He lives next door. Tall and round he is for sure. We always play together. We share jokes and snacks. We go to different schools with the same blue bags. Very good. So, can you repeat after me again? Golu is my neighbor. He lives next door. Tall and round he is for sure. We always play together. We share jokes and snacks. We go to different schools with the same blue bags. Right. You can recite this poem 2 to 3 times. Now, time for a reality check. Here's our question. Mr. and Mrs. Seth are Kanika's neighbors. They are very old. Their children live in America. They live alone. How can Kanika help them? You can only mark a tick on correct answers. As I read, you can listen. Please listen carefully and tick on right options. The first option is read stories with them. Right? You can tick right here in this box like this. Okay? Read stories with them. That one a correct answer. Second, water their plants. So, water their plants is a right one, right thing. You can tick right here. Write on their walls. No, that one is a bad thing. You can cross or you can just leave this box. Okay. Next option is not make noise when it's time for them to rest. Yes. You cannot make noises because they are aged people, right? So you just tick on here. Next, play loud music and disturb them. No, never. As you can cross or you just leave this box. Play games with them. Yes, tick on here. Throw garbage in front of their house. That is very bad thing. Don't do it ever again. Ever. Last one is help them to carry shopping bags. Right on here. This one is a genuinely good habits. Now your time. What will you do in the given situation? Mark a tick. Just a tick on right options. There are two options each. First question is, new neighbors have come next to my house. What will you do to help them? First option, carry their bags in. Second option, stand outside and watch them. If you want a good neighbor, actually we have to help everyone, right? So the first option is right, carry their bags in. You can tick right here. Second question is, you are walking in the park, you meet your neighbor, what will you do? First option, ignore him and walk away. Smile and greet him. The second option is right, tick here, smile and greet him. Third question is, you are playing with your friends in the park, a new neighbor wants to join you, what will you do? Make him play with you or ignore him? So you always make him play with you. That first option is right. Here, the right tick. Now our last question is put together. Now this is a question you can write in your own feelings onwards. Question is, Mrs. Grace is a good neighbor. She is helping Mrs. Singh to carry the vegetable bags. Write down four ways in which you can be a good neighbor. So as you see this picture, there's many good things, right? Picking other bag as you learn from the lesson, helping each other, don't make noises when other one, your neighbor, especially old one, taking rest or sleep. So there's a different types of things you can do to help your neighbors, right? So you can just write there, and you see in your textbook there are four options, four numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can just write four things what you have to do or you can do for your neighbors if you want a good neighbor. Okay, as we always want a good neighbor, as we expect other people, so we can do ourselves first, right? Thank you.